Hello friends, welcome to Deception. This is the second part of calorimetry where I am going to solve numericals based on specific capacity. Do watch the first video whose link will be given in the top right corner. If you do like this video, hit the thumbs up button, the subscribe button and do share it with your friends. Let us move with the first question. It is, calculate the heat capacity of a copper vessel of mass 150 gram if the specific heat capacity of copper is 410 joule per kilogram per Kelvin. So the mass of copper has been given as 150 gram and specific capacity, which is denoted by C, has been mentioned as 410 joule per kilogram per Kelvin. Now since it is in kilogram, you have to convert mass into kilogram, which will be done by dividing it by 1000, right? And further, to find the heat capacity, we have the relation C dash equals M into C, right? So this heat capacity will be given by 150 by 1000 into 410. This will be, and 51 is a 15, 5 carry 1, 15 4 is a 61, 61 divided by 10 to give a point. 61.5 joule per Kelvin. The next part is, how much heat energy will be required to increase the temperature of the vessel in part A from 25 degree centigrade to 35 degree centigrade? Well, this part can be solved in two ways, by using heat capacity or using specific heat capacity. You have the relation Q equals, sorry, specific heat capacity equals Q by delta T. You can use this, that is Q equals C dash delta T. So C dash we have found out, that was 61.5 joule per Kelvin into change in temperature, that is 35 minus 25 degree C. So 61.5 into 10 will give you 615 joule. Or you can find out by the use of specific capacity as given in the question, which will be given by Q equal MC delta T. You can put the data, 150 by 1000 into C, that is 410 into change in temperature, that is 10. So in both ways, you can do it to obtain the answer 615 joule. Let us move on to the second question, which is, an electron heater of power 1000 volt raises temperature of a 5 kg of a liquid from 25 degree centigrade to 31 degree centigrade in 2 minutes. You have to calculate the heat capacity and the specific heat capacity of the liquid. Let's proceed by writing the information, that is, mass of the liquid is 5 kg, then power of the heater is 1000 watt, or you can say in joule per second, right? Then you have change in temperature, that is 31 minus 21, which is 6 degrees C, and temperature is, sorry, time is 2 minutes. You can convert into seconds because joule per second. So let us proceed. You have power, you know power equals what? Q by delta T. So that implies Q equals power into change in temperature, sorry, Q by T, time. So P into time. Now P is 1000 volt and time is 120. So that can be written as 1, 3, 4, so 1.2 into 10 to the power 5 joule. Now to find the heat capacity, you know heat capacity equals heat gain, heat required for per degree centigrade rise in temperature of the body. So Q is 1.2 into 10 to the power 5 divided by change in temperature, that is 6. So this will give you 0.2, or you can say 2 into 10 to the power 4 and joule per Kelvin or joule per degree centigrade. In second part, we have to find the specific heat capacity of the liquid. So C equals C dash into M, sorry, C dash divided by M. So C dash is 2 into 10 to the power 4 and mass has been given as 5. Got it? So this can cut 2 into 10 to the power 3 into 10 by 5. So this will give you 2. So 4 into 10 to the power 3 joule per kilogram per Kelvin. Moving on to the next question, that is question number 3. पहले इस प्रॉब्लम को करने से पहले मैं आपको कुछ एक्सपीरियंस आपको याद दिलाना चाहता हूँ। जब हमारी मम्मी हमें दूध पीने के लिए देती थी तो क्या होता था, अगर वो बेसी गर्म होता था तो हमारी मम्मी उसे एक पतीले पानी में रख देती थी थोड़ी देर के लिए। उससे क्या होता था, जो दूध गर्म था वो थोड़ा ठंडा हो जाता था, तो वो जो गर्मी थी वो गई कहाँ, वो एक्चुअली उस पानी में ट्रांसमिट हो जाती थी। अगर आपने उस पानी को छुआ होगा तो पानी पहले से थोड़ा गर्म हो जाता था, यानी वो जो हीट था वो उसमें ट्रांसफर हो जाता था। वही प्रिंसिपल हम यहाँ पर इस्तेमाल करने वाले हैं, जो कि है प्रिंसिपल ऑफ कैलोरीमेट्री। ठीक, प्रॉब्लम क्या है, अ बकेट कंटेन्स 8 किलोग्राम ऑफ वाटर एट 25 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड, 2 किलोग्राम ऑफ वाटर एट 80 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड इज पोर्ड इनटू इट, नेगलेक्टिंग द हीट एनर्जी अब्सॉर्ब बाय द बकेट, कैलकुलेट द फाइनल टेंपरेचर ऑफ वाटर। चलिए पहले हम देख लेते हैं क्या है डेटास। अगर हम इसे एज्यूम करते हैं M1 क्या है ये 8 किलोग्राम, और दूसरे वाले के M2 जो कि पोर किया गया 2 किलोग्राम। इसका इनिशियल टेंपरेचर डिनोट करेंगे हम Ti से, ये है 25 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड, Ti1 कर लेते हैं, और ये है आपका 80 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड। अब ये दोनों मिक्स होंगे जब, तो एक फाइनल टेंपरेचर रीच होगा जहां पर हीट ट्रांसफर रुक जाएगा, वो होगा, लेट कर लेते हैं हम उसे, लेट द फाइनल टेंपरेचर बी टी डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड, राइट, तभी ट्रांसफर होगा। क्या है प्रिंसिपल ऑफ कैलोरीमेट्री, अगर हीट लॉस को नेग्लिजिबल माना जाए, नेग्लेक्ट किया जाए, तो हीट लॉस बाय द हॉट बॉडी इक्वल्स हीट गेन बाय द कोल्ड बॉडी। तो क्या होगा, M1C1 डेल टी 1 इक्वल्स M2C2 डेल टी 2। बोथ केसेस क्या है, वाटर है तो स्पेसिफिक कैपेसिटी सेम होगा। M1 क्या है 8 किलोग्राम, चेंज इन टेंपरेचर क्योंकि ये कोल्ड बॉडी है तो ये क्या करेगा, हीट गेन करेगा, दैट इज T-25, ये कितना है 2 किलोग्राम, ये हॉट है तो ये हीट लॉस करेगा जो कि होगा 80-T। नाउ इसे हम कैंसिल भी कर सकते हैं, क्या हो गया ये 40-100 इक्वल्स 80-T, ये इधर आ गया, क्या हो जाएगा 5T इक्वल्स 180, या T इक्वल टू 180 बाय 5, दैट इज 36 डिग्री सी। सो गाइस, टिल नाउ वी हैव डन प्रॉब्लम्स इन व्हिच वी आर फाइंड टू हीट कैपेसिटी, स्पेसिफिक कैपेसिटी एंड द हीट एनर्जी रिक्वायर्ड। इन दिस प्रॉब्लम वी हैव टू फाइंड मास, लेट अस लुक एट द प्रॉब्लम। वी हैव व्हाट मास ऑफ लिक्विड ए ऑफ स्पेसिफिक कैपेसिटी 0.84 जूल किलोग्राम पर केल्विन एट अ टेंपरेचर ऑफ 40 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड मस्ट बी मिक्स्ड विद 100 ग्राम ऑफ लिक्विड बी ऑफ स्पेसिफिक कैपेसिटी 2.1 जूल किलोग्राम पर केल्विन एट 20 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड सो दैट द फाइनल टेंपरेचर बिकम्स 32 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड। लेट अस सॉल्व दिस। नाउ लिक्विड ए, यू हैव टू फाइंड द मास, योर स्पेसिफिक कैपेसिटी ऑफ liquid A is 0.84 joule per kilogram per kelvin and the initial temperature of A is 40 degree centigrade, the final temperature is 32 degree centigrade. So delta change in temperature equals what, 40 minus 32, that equals 8 degree C. For liquid B, we have mass equals 100 gram, the specific capacity is 2.1 joule per kilogram per kelvin, the delta change in temperature is 20 is the initial temperature, so the change in temperature will be 32 minus 20, that is 12 degree C. If we consider no heat is lost in the surrounding, then by the principle of calorimetry we will have m into ca into ta del ta, sorry, MB, CB and del TB, right? So M we have to find out, CA is 0.84, change in temperature is 8, MB is 100, CB is 2.1 and change in temperature is 12. So M will equal 100 into 2.1 into 12 by 0.84 into 8, this will give 100 and this will give 10. So 21 4 is 0, 4 25 is 0, 4 again 25 is 0, right, we have 2 6 is 0, 25 6 is 150, now 150 into 25 by 10, this will cancel this, and 15 5 is 25, 15 5 is 75, 5 carry 7, 15 to the 30, 375, and since the mass is in gram, so it would be 375 gram. That's your answer. We have moved on to the last problem of this section. If you have any problem related to any of the problems, any of the questions, if you have any queries, you can write down in our comment box. Well, let's see this problem. In this problem, 1 kilogram of water is contained in a 1.25 kilowatt kettle. You have to calculate the time taken for the temperature of water to rise from 25 degrees centigrade to its boiling point, that is 100 degrees centigrade. The specific cabinet of water, you know, that's 4.2 joule per gram per kelvin. So the solution will be, the mass is 1 kilogram, sorry, and the power of the kettle has been given as 1.25 kilowatt. You can convert it into what? 1.25 into 10 to the power 3 volt. Then you have to calculate the time, and the temperature has been given 25 to 100. So change in temperature will be 100 minus 25, that equals 75, and the heat capacity is 4.2 joule per gram per kelvin. Since it is in gram, you should convert this into gram, that is 1 into 1000, that is 1000 gram, right? You know, power equals Q by T, right? Or you can say T equals Q by P. Now Q is MC delta T and divided by power. So mass is 1000 gram, C is 4.2, change in temperature is 75 degrees C, and P is 1.25 into 10 to the power 3. Now this gets cancelled, right? You can have this 100, you can have this as 10. Now this will cancel, 25 3 0, 25 5 0, this will be cancelled, 5 2 0. So 42 into 6, right? 42 2 0 84, 84 into 3 4 3 0 12, 2 carry 1, 8 3 0 24 1, 252 252. Seconds you will have, since power is in volt, that is joule per second. So this is 252 seconds. To convert this into minutes, you can divide it by 60. So that will give us 4 minutes and 12 seconds. Well, that's it for this video. If you have any problems, you can comment down in our comment box. New videos are coming soon. Till then, stay tuned. And if you haven't subscribed yet, subscribe to our channel.